Hi guys, it's Danny. Today we find ourselves outside because we're going to talk about the outside orchids. But don't worry, we're going to go back in the grow space really fast because the noise is just out of this world. But first, let's just take a look at the orchids. I didn't show you the setup because I was not sure if I'm going to keep it. And I'm still not sure if I'm going to keep this specific setup. I have the goods and the bad for you today, of course. Not all of these orchids appreciated the outside world. I myself don't really appreciate taking care of these orchids outside on my terrace. It's just a lot of work, but there are some benefits. So the setup is nothing to write home about. This is my IKEA stand. I just don't use it in my grow space anymore, so I decided to use it outside. And this is good because, as I was saying, my terrace is just the windiest thing ever, and until I find a solution to break the wind, I cannot have pots just sitting on shelves because when I least expect, they will all be on the floor. So being that the IKEA stand actually keeps the pots in place, I don't have any issues, and it's the only way that I can grow these orchids without having problems. The heavier pots can be down, but even with them, if the orchids are very tall, there is a very high risk they're gonna fall. So that's one of the downsides. And I told you in my yesterday's video, I think, that one of my cattleyas had a bend over new growth because of the wicked wind. And I'm hoping it's not going to affect the audio of this video. But yeah, wind is a nuisance. And if I just wanna come and look at my orchids, I'm gonna have to deal with the wind, and it's just too much for me. Therefore, I only look at them early in the morning or late in the afternoon. Now, the location is an eastern one. They receive a couple of hours of direct sunshine, maybe 3 hours in the early morning, and then they're shaded. And afterwards, in the late afternoon, they might actually get a little bit of more sun, but that's about it. So I don't have any burning of the sorts. Probably if I would keep my Vandas here, it would be great, but I'm not sure if it's enough light for the Vandas. For the cattleyas, it kind of is. But that's about it. Most of the day, they are in bright shade. Which, you know, I was thinking maybe the grow space is a little bit better, but I have some good results. So first of all, I do have here mainly cattleyas, brassavolas, and cattleya family orchids, but I also have some oncidiums. As you can see, there are some dendrobiums, which I will show you. The best performers are the cattleya types and the dendrobium phalaenopsis types. Everything else, so and so. Oh, and the epidendrums, the reed stems. But stuff like the Dendrobium nobilis, they're not all that happy. And I'm not referring to the yellowing leaves. Those are old growth and it's normal for them to happen. I'm referring to the new leaves. They're just not as vigorous and luscious as they used to be. Oh, are the workers quiet? We might actually be able to sit on the terrace for this video. We'll see how it goes. So yeah, as you can see, they don't look all that happy. They have grown a lot better in my grow space, and I think they're going back, and that is that. But it's okay, these orchids are easy to bloom, even if they don't receive a lot of light during summertime, so I'm good with them. Also, some other orchids which I'm not sure I want to keep on the terrace anymore are the Oncidiums. I have Oncidium, Cherry Baby, and Relatives here, nothing else. But I already have a lot of pitting on the leaf. That's the second one, and I'm guessing it has to do with the temperature. Oh my god, this guy needs water. We'll talk about watering. Somebody at the American Orchid Society in a webinar, they were saying that Oncidiums, these types at least, they have a very narrow temperature range in which they grow well, and if it gets too hot or too cold, they will get spotting on their leaves. I don't know if that's the case really. I've always had spots on the leaves, but I do tend to believe that heat or sun exposure, but mainly heat, affects them and affects the foliage. Other than that, they are doing well. This guy over there has a flower spike. It's very thin, but it's growing. But you can see, I do have that pitting on the leaf, the little dotting. They're prone. Many of them do have this dotting. I'm thinking in climates which are more cool and more humid, I'm thinking they will look better. But everything that has Soto Annum in it, meaning Twinkles, Cherry Babies, the Redolence one or the Sweet 16, I'm not sure what the variety name is, and even the Soto Annum, they all get really spotted leaf tips, and that is that. in hot climates, apparently more than in cooler climates. What to do? It's okay, it's nothing to worry about, in the sense that the orchid is perfectly fine, it just does not look good. But these two are the only types of orchids that didn't really appreciate the terrace. The calleas, on the other hand, and as I'm talking, I will show you some examples, there's something going on with the calleas, you guys. So first of all, they are growing much faster. Second of all, they are growing much more vigorous. Third of all, they are putting out multiple directions of growth. I noticed the BC Saint André has three directions of growth. How is that even possible? Up until now, for a year and a half or two, she only had one direction. Now she has three. And she's not the only one. I do have a few cattleyas which do produce multiple directions of growth at the moment, which they never did. The ones that don't, I'm noticing much more vigorous new growth. And the new growth is just growing much, much faster. Even if, yes, it's summertime, but in the growth space, not even in the summer, they wouldn't grow so fast. So I am noticing a big difference with the cattleya types, Brassavola types, cattleya family in general. They do grow much more vigorous, faster, and just better overall. So let's hope for blooms. Some of them matured growth already and they didn't bloom, and now they're working on new growth. They're kind of hurrying up, so hopefully those will bloom. And to be fully honest, that's the only thing that still keeps them out here, because caring for them, it's painful. So these orchids, do you know how often they need water? At least every 2 days. And now that it's not so hot, aka not 40 degrees Celsius, it's just 35. Now, maybe once every 2 days I can get away. I thought I could also get away with the fact that I do have a hose and I can bring it here and flush the pots. Oh, no, I cannot really do that too often because I have salt deposits on some of these orchids. On the Leca, that is, look at this. So I cannot really flush them or use the hose and the tap water as often as I would like. So not only can I not use the hose, but to bring the hose here, it's a struggle because it starts way in the back of the terrace. There is some furniture and some stuff that I don't need, let's say, on this terrace that just makes everything so complicated. It's just not ideal. I'm working on making it functional, but hey, it takes a while. So bringing the hose here, it's just awful. I have bruises on my legs because of the hose being brought here and the fact that I need to jump over stuff to actually make it. And also, when I use the hose, I'm just spilling water everywhere. Everybody gets a drench, everybody shares water. And at some point I was like, I don't care anymore. I have these orchids for many, many, many years. It's fine. And I recently removed the dishes because they were flowing anyway. But I'm thinking I'm gonna bring them back. I watered them once like that, and I was just, I am scared about disease now. So yeah, I shared water once, but I didn't like it. A good thing about hosing these orchids down though, and let me just show you this with aerial roots, is the branching aspect of it. When I water down my orchids and just water falls everywhere, the aerial roots are getting watered as well, and just look at this. It's absolutely amazing. So yeah, it's nice. It's nice to share water sometimes, but it's so scary. I don't want to do it anymore. I thought I would be okay with it since I do know these orchids for quite a lot of time and they're okay. I thought it would be easy, but no, I just don't want to share water. So yeah, the trays will go back, and no more hosing them down. Yeah, either I change the setup and actually hose them down without them dripping on each other, either I don't know. I have mixed feelings about it. And it's just overall a hassle. Everything is a hassle with these orchids outside. I am actually considering a self-watering system for them just to make the watering aspect a lot easier, because it is so incredibly annoying. It becomes a hassle. So yeah, I was considering to bring them inside, end of story. But I do like how some of these grow, and I just want to push forward and just wreck my brain for a better setup, one that doesn't share water, one that doesn't make me water every day or every 2 days. And yeah, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna stick to it and I'm gonna do it. I see some results and there's no denying they are. So the cattleyas are some orchids that are really, really doing well. But the next group of orchids which are just booming right now is the Phalaenopsis type dendrobiums, or Bigibbum type dendrobiums for those of you who want to be more correct than others. So I'm just gonna show you each and every one of them. Somebody asked me if I can pan out so you can see a better look of the terrace. I cannot. I have neighbors. I cannot show you their properties. I cannot show anything that surrounds me, which is private property. Anywhere you look on this terrace, there's a private property. So I really do want to install some trees, bushes, shrubs, something that will, one, break the wind, and second, offer me some privacy. I have no privacy right now. Like, people on the street in their cars are seeing me right now. Anyway, so yeah, I cannot pan out, but if I manage to offer myself some privacy, I will pan out. Obviously, I have nothing to hide. There's nothing amazing on this terrace. I just don't want to show you private property. So the Dendrobium phalaenopsis are just growing like crazy. And not only the ones that I already have for a while and they completely adjusted to my climate and to my routine, no. All of them, even the ones that are set back, are now growing their new growths a lot better. They're growing vigorous, they have a lot of roots, they have thick and luscious leaves and good looking sturdy pseudobulbs. Is just amazing. I'm convinced these orchids are doing so much better outside, and they're actually in the most sun out of everything. They're actually further on the terrace and they don't get burned. I mean, Vanda's burned easier than them, which is surprising. But yeah, some of them are already producing flower spikes. One of them is in bloom, but overall they're growing so amazingly well. So for them, as you can see, they do have their little trays. I didn't share water with them, so at least that. But I'm thinking to make a self-watering system for them because I do want to keep them outside. There is such a massive difference between how they grow in the growth space and how they do outside. They enjoy the heat, the sun. Of course, I'm not going to keep them in the afternoon sun, but they do get until 11 o'clock, even 12 o'clock in some areas. They do still get sun and they don't burn. They're great. Afterwards though, they're in the shade, and when the sun sets, they get a little bit more, an hour or two of setting sun type of light, which is okay for them, and they've done amazing. But again, they just dry out so fast and they drink so much water right now because they're growing. I really need to do a self-watering system for them. And yeah, I'm gonna keep them outside in the summertime and warmer months because it's absolutely worth it with them. So right now I do need to put inside the Oncidiums, the Dendrobium nobilis. I also have on the terrace the Epidendrums, but they're doing great. And the Engraecum vici, or Vici, sorry, he's doing great too. But the nobilis and the Oncidiums, no. I need to bring them in. And yeah, I'll let you know when I decide how I will improve the setup and what I'm gonna do about the drying out situation. So alrighty guys, this has been the video with the outside orchids. Hopefully it wasn't very annoying with the sounds in the background, but there we go. It's never quiet here, you guys. What to do? But anyway, thank you so much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have ideas for me for the outside orchids and how I can like make my life easier, I would appreciate if you'd give me some ideas down below in the comment section. I always pull inspiration from your ideas. And you know the drill. If you've enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe to my channel for regular orchid videos, tutorials, experiments, and orchid related stuff. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you whenever I upload a new video, just turn on all notifications for my channel. And with that said, I'll see you all next time. Bye!